Hello and welcome to this edition of Ask Dr. Robyn. I'm Dr. Robyn Silverman, Child and Teen Development Specialist and the creator of the Powerful Words Character System. Today's letter is from Tara in Mountain Lakes, New Jersey, who writes, "Dear Dr. Robyn, sometimes my five-year-old girl gets so angry that she nearly explodes. My husband and I privately call her the hurricane. We are just not sure how to help her calm down and keep herself from getting so mad. We find ourselves tiptoeing around so we don't set her off." Well, thank you, Tara. Dealing with anger is hard. That hot-headed, pent-up energy can make people act in ways that they never would behave at times when that emotion is dormant. And I'm not just talking about children. Adults have this problem too. In a moment of calm, talk to your child about anger and how to best deal with these tough feelings. Healthy people, including children, experience anger, but instead of trying to avoid it or act on it, they manage it in productive ways. So here are some tips. Number one, give words to their feelings. When we give our children the correct words to talk about their feelings, emotions go from bottled up inside to out where they can be supported. "Oh, I see that you feel angry because your friend took your ball," or, "I can tell that you feel hurt because your sister isn't listening to you." Eventually, your script will translate into skills they use. Number two, get them in touch with what happened before they got angry. If your child yelled or pushed or bit or threw a tantrum, help them to hone in on what happened before the volcano erupted inside them. Ask them, "What happened right before you got angry? What did you see? What did you hear? What did you feel? What did you think?" When children are able to learn the warning signs that trigger them, they can make adjustments to keep them calmer and less overwhelmed. Number three, teach calming techniques. There are many ways that children can release or redirect their anger so that they don't hurt themselves or others. For example, they can count backwards, they can ask for a hug, sing, or do yoga. They can engage in a calming activity like reading a book or building with blocks. They can drum on a drum. What works best for your child? Lastly, don't forget to teach your children to repair their relationships. When they make a mistake in anger, make sure they apologize and repair the damage. That's all for this edition for Ask Dr. Robyn. Please continue to send in your questions and it may be featured next time. In the meantime, I hope you make it a very powerful month. Thank you, everyone.